The HOA has hired a geological firm. They came out yesterday. They did some GPR around the site. While they were out here, I asked them if they would, behind us, go over the roadway because we've had some activity over there. So he ran his GPR over that area, and a preliminary report says that there is a large void under the roadway. He says it's approximately 17 feet wide. We don't have a depth yet or a length because he only went in one direction. So out of an abundance of safety, we've decided to go ahead and close the roadway down. We've met with the HOA. We've met with the residents that are being affected here. They were very happy and more cordial to us and agreed with us 100%. So with the activity still ongoing, our depressions are growing. We're up to 36 of them now. We cannot put anybody in the area to do the actual GPR. So the company that is doing this is rigging up a tether system in order for them to have the ability to pull the GPR back and forth and keeping everybody out of harm's way. So when that is completed, the HOA will get a report of what is actually going on in the site. We can't tell. We don't know. We're here for support for the HOA. We're here for support for our citizens. So like I said, in abundance of safety, we've gone ahead and closed down the roadway. And I'll open it up for questions right now.
So if it's entered beyond just this retention pond, is it beyond the HOA's ability to take over something of this
Well, unfortunately, Pasco County, we own the road surface. The HOA actually owns the dirt and ground underneath it. However, because we're going to have to make the repair, we're going to go ahead and fill that void in and hopefully mitigate it. Time-wise, we do not have a time span or duration of how long this is going to take. It's going to be dependent on the report that the HO gets and hands to us so we can work with our engineers and road work and road and bridge.
Is there concerns about these houses right here?
Well, these houses over here, this house has a depression behind it. They filled it in and mitigated it. The house across two houses down also had a depression in front of it. They've mitigated it. There's pockets throughout. You need to remember, this area at one time was a flowing river. They built on top of a flowing river and connected the land together to build the houses. And I have a saying that if you take from Mother Nature is going to take it back eventually. So we can't tell when holes are going to pop up, depressions are going to pop up, anomalies are going to pop up. It's very hard to tell in this area.
Are you guys evacuating any houses or anything?
No, ma'am. The building inspectors have been out here. They're all structurally safe. There's no integrity problems. The homeowners feel comfortable staying. We come out here every day. We talk with them. We ask them, have you seen anything different, any cracks or anything like that? And so far, they all feel very safe.
But that's not exactly what you're dealing with here, right?
No, it's exactly the opposite. The sinkhole that happened in Land O'Lakes in Lake Paget area was a catastrophic sinkhole. And what I mean by that, a catastrophic sinkhole is large, it opens, and it swallows everything in one fell swoop. Over here, they're little pocket depressions. I can't classify them as sinkholes, but they're depressions that are over that active cave system. So that cave system might be collapsing a little bit. They might be interconnected underneath, and where one opens up, another one underneath there might open up beside it. So we cannot tell until they actually get this report done. How big is the void? What are we looking at? How far is it going to go? Time, distance, and speed is basically what it's going to come down to.
Can you talk a little bit more about the data that you got yesterday from the ground penetrative radar? I mean, is that you don't know, I guess, how deep the pockets are, or would that
Well,
data show that?
when they did the scan over ground, they found the void. It shows up on their system and will show a void. But we're unable to tell how deep or actually how long it's going to be. He went only in one direction to the west. He never came through this side of the roadside yet. So, but when he got done, he went back to his office. He pulled the information that he had and he gave us a preliminary that you have a 17-foot void underneath there. And that's when he says, I can't tell you how deep or how long until I finish doing the rest of the work and I'm able to put all the data points together.
So would it be like 17 feet like into the roadway then? Can you kind of like
It's 17 feet in length this way.
This way.
And from where he started, and you know, it's actually going back the opposite way where my vehicle's parked. So he went 17 feet that way. So he says there's a void underneath there. It covers apparently the entire road width, but he did not say coming this way. He just started, when he started that, there was the void. So.
But, do we have the size of this one now? It was 25 feet like 2 days ago. Do we have a better?
It's grown approximately about another 2.5 foot. We've come out here and marked it every day, and every day we come out and mark it again because the paint's gone. And when the paint goes away, that means it's either sloughing off or it's still more activity in there. The one to the right that we're talking about still has water in it. So we were thinking that maybe, we were hoping that it was just possibly rainwater, but it's a brackish type water, so it's more conducive of it being aquifer water.
Any of the 36 depressions threatening any structures?
Not at this time. They're all located within this small area. Some of the ones that, like the one over there and the one back there, we have counted that in there also, but they're not structurally endangering anything right now.
So could you explain a little bit about how some of those, the holes we're seeing might actually be one under the ground?
Right. So you have a hole open up on one side, you have a hole open up on another side, or a depression, however you want to state it. And underneath there, that might be one entire cavern, one entire cave. So all it's doing is the clay layer that's in the clay layer that's on the land, what happens after a while, it's very caustic in this cave. So that limestone is continually eroding away. So it gets to a point that with all the rain that we have, saturates the ground, and there's a clay layer and then another sand layer, and that clay layer finally says I'm done and breaks away. So you might get a little opening here, and then with the weight over here you might get that weight over there, and it does the same exact thing.
How deep we're talking?
Not at this time I don't.
Do you think that the road will start caving in over here? Do you have to let it continue to cave in, if so, before you can even come, since it's active?
Well, once we get the report back and we see how far is that void below the road surface and what is it going to take to mitigate it. That's why we close it, because we have school buses that go through here. We have garbage trucks, cement mixers, dump trucks, and all that excess weight is just putting pressure on it. I don't even feel comfortable putting a passenger car on there. And it's not because I think it's going to collapse. It's just the thought of it having the potential to collapse.
Sidewalk okay though?
Yes. Yes.
Urging people not to walk through here,
We've urged the citizens. We've had talk with very many. I talked with the HOA president. We're getting a lot of lookers that want to come up here and drive up here, and they stop and they go wandering along. And we've told them, do not do this. You have a potential to fall in. I fell in just standing on the ground by itself. The HOA president yesterday, I was having a conversation with him walking, and I turn, he's gone, he fell in. So that whole area is very unstable, and we're urging the citizens and the residents just to stay away from the area.
What was that like?
The fall in?
Yeah.
I used a bunch of words I shouldn't have and grabbed the fence and held on. Yeah, it was sudden. I mean, I was talking to my one of my coordinators, and next thing you know, the ground just gave way, and I was about almost knee deep. So that's the potential we have out here right now.
Andy, can you spell your last name for us?
FOSSA.
And your title again?
Emergency Management Director.
And I realize you're not an engineer, but how do you mitigate something like this when it's done?
That's going to be up to the HOA and what they decide to do. They could dredge it out and try leveling it. They could try filling it. One's a lot more expensive than the other, so it's going to be up to them. Any other questions?
If there are all these depressions falling at the same rate, is there any pattern?
There's no pattern to it whatsoever. It started on the 13th, August 13th, and every day except for one day in the last week and a half, we've had a phone call about them. So they're just popping open, and meaning that we came out here yesterday and found, I think, three more that had opened up. So they just pop up on their own. There's no rhyme or reason why they're doing it.
And they're still active and growing, is that
yes.
accurate?
Yes.
So we have no idea how long this will be shut down?
No. We're hoping as soon as we get the report and HOA gives us a plan with them, that the county will come up with their plan and the repair will start right away.
When should that report be expected?
I do not know. It's usually about a week. They have said, and we have talked with them, they have said they are making this a priority just because of the size and the activity that's going on, to get us a report, well, not us, get the HOA a report in. So hopefully it'll be within the week.
I heard from one homeowner, I think they had some broken pipes or something underneath their house or inside their house. Should they be concerned and should people be worried that there could be holes underneath their house?
Absolutely. The way this area has a very large sinkhole area. It's been proven there's 354 residents out here. Out of the 354, 187 of these residents have been sinkhole remediations. So this area is prone for that. And especially during the wet part of the season like we're in now, the depressions are more prone to pop up. We try to keep a historical data on everything, so that way we can follow patterns and trends. We work closely with USF. They were out here yesterday. They did a great job flying the area, gridding it out, and they got some excellent topography on here. So we work in conjunction with them, and it works out quite well. Any other questions?
How about over here? When they shut this down?
Yes, ma'am. Well, I'm sure the trash company will be able to back in and pull out. But as for the onlookers, I cannot control the onlookers.
Okay, so if they get in here and get walking around, we call the cops?
Call the sheriff's office.
Yeah.
We've spoken to them already this morning
yeah.
to let them know about the road closure. We've also spoken with the HOA because this HOA has a no-curb parking policy, and we're going to have these cars on the roadway for a little while and not to ticket them because we're in a...
So we don't call 911.
Just call the sheriff's department. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I watch the kids that are around these things. Now, you know, we holler at them, they holler back at us, but I've seen kids get very close to the
Unfortunately, I wish I had a way to control it.
Again, I'll call the sheriff's department, but I don't want to see them get hurt.
Yes, ma'am, I agree 100%. 100%.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Anybody else, any other questions? All right, with that, I'll conclude it, and you guys have a safe day.